الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على نبيه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا مزيدا إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. As the middle of Ramadan passes, some lose the flavor and pleasure of fasting. Some already lost it, some never had it, and there's few who had it and will continue to have it until the end of Ramadan. May Allah allow us to be among those few. There's different types of fasting. And the type of fast that we want is the fast that comes with pleasure. Not just any ordinary fast. We want to attain pleasure while we're fasting. We want to attain coolness of the eyes in fasting. We want to be ecstatic that we're fasting. Look at the verse in the Quran. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ كَمَا كُتِبَ عَلَى الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ Oh, you believe fasting has been prescribed upon you? Why? To achieve taqwa. To achieve taqwa. You don't see anywhere in the verse a direct order that you need to find pleasure and coolness of the eyes in fasting. You don't see that in the verse. Why? Masses of the ummah may not attain pleasure in fasting or salah. But it's the exceptional few who do. We want to be among the few. We want to be among the few who do. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about salah, He mentions the purpose of salah. إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنْ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ It's a prayer. The purpose is to sway one from fahsha, which is great sins, major sins, and munkar, which is disbelief and polytheism, shirk. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that prayer was coolness of his eyes and ultimate pleasure to him. وَجُعِلَتْ قُرَّةُ عَيْنِ فِي الصَّلَاةِ What I'm trying to get at is Allah stated in the Quran the purpose of fasting as taqwa. Allah in the Quran stated the purpose of salah to deter one from sins and disbelief. That there, those are purposes and characteristics everyone over the course of time must achieve in those worships. Everyone must attain taqwa, refrain from disbelief, refrain from major sins. That's for everyone. But there's a higher level than that for the special ones. There's an internal higher level than that. It has deep meanings and goals. It's for the super special ones. It's just like your faith as a whole. Your faith as a whole has levels. You start off with Islam. Above that is Iman. And the third category above all those is Ihsan. The high level of fasting is when you're enjoying and having pleasure in your fast. Because it's for the sake of Allah. Attaining coolness of the eyes in your fast. Only special people get this. And it's a feel only achieved when one fasts while feeling Allah's watching over him. أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه. As if you're seeing Allah as well. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam goes to al-Ta'if, a mountain so difficult to climb. The Sahaba died climbing it. When he reached the top of the mountain, they pelt him with stones all the way down to the valley. He bleeds, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He's tired. He's deep in deep agony. Yet look at his amazing, stunning words: "In lam yakum bika alayya ghadabun fala ubali." Oh Allah, if you're not mad at me, all that happened, that's nothing. If you're not mad at me, all I went through, basically what he's saying, is like ice cold water quenching the thirst of someone very thirsty. As long as you're not mad at me. Ya subhanallah. Such beautiful, eloquent brightness from the brightness of revelation, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So are you trying to tell me, someone's going to say, are you trying to tell me we can have pleasure while being hungry? If it's for the sake of Allah, most definitely yes. Some seek pleasure in food and only in food and love that. And that's a characteristic that Allah said the non-believers share with the cattle. الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا يَتَمَتَّعُونَ وَيَأْكُلُونَ كَمَا تَأْكُلُ الْأَنْعَامِ Their life roams around food. That's all it's about. To a believer, there are times when being hungry feels better and more satisfying than when you satisfy your hunger. Only some people can understand this. The pleasure, the delight, the enjoyment, the thrill. The aroma of fasting comes when you know you're serving Allah. Look at the hadith. الصوم لي وأنا أجزي به. ترك طعامه وشهوته من أجلي. Numerous hadith, a hadith Qudsiyah, where Allah is stressing to us that fasting is for me. They leave this for me. They leave their desire for me. You have to understand you're doing this for Allah. In order to enjoy it, you have to understand you're doing it for Allah. That's the meaning of iman and ihtisab, the one we talked about in the first khatira. Once you do, I won't even say fasting, but even lashes of the whips and stones that penetrate the flesh to the bones in the hot sun of Mecca, like what happened to Bilal, become pleasurable, knowing that they're for the sake of Allah. Let me give you this example that'll bring it home to you who are young. And this example is sufficient to show you the meaning of this whole khatira. Someone has a fiancé, a wife. He goes to the store, he buys her a gift. He runs from mall to mall. It's raining, it's snowing, it's in hot weather like we have today. He's trying to get the best gift possible at the best price, the one that best suits his wife. He wraps it, then he hands it to her. And of course, the same applies to sister giving it to her husband. Then they sit back and watch them unwrap that present while they're happy. And the person who got it sits with delight and joy beyond that which words can even express, due to their extreme love. Their extreme love in trying to please their spouse. They forgot about all the hardship. What hardship? Well, he went shopping, walking to stores, sometimes having to have to work for weeks and months and years to pay for it. What made them forget about all that hardship at the sight of their loved one opening that gift and getting happy? It's love for that person. Another example, bring this closer to home. My mother, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala raise her rank to Firdaus, and all your mothers. She used to stand on her blessed feet all day cooking, especially in days like these days of Ramadan, preparing the most delicious meals you could eat. Most of the time, it was for family. Sometimes it would be for hundreds of guests that we used to get. She wakes up as with every day before. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant her Firdaus al-A'la for the pain she suffered and endured. Before Fajr, she'd wake up for Qiyam. Then she'd stand up around, in and around the kitchen all day long. Then at Maghrib, after hours and hours and hours of work, we consume it within less than 15 minutes. When she sees her husband, her daughters, her son, her grandkids, and the guests eating, she gets overwhelmed with pleasure. Not once in the decades did we ever hear her say, "I've been standing on my feet for hours and hours preparing that meal." Or as she got older, with that most extreme back pain that she used to have, never did she say, "I've been standing on my feet for hours and hours and I'm suffering." In fact, you can see the happiness on her face as she pushes us to eat more. And when she was cooking and suffering, she forgot all about that suffering, first and foremost for the ajr, but for also after that, for and because of her love to us. That leads us to the understanding of this issue, attaining pleasure in fasting. When you give your taste buds and your stomach what it was created for, it feels pleasure. Which is food and water, of course. When you give your heart and soul what it was created for, then it'll find pleasure. In order for you to feel pleasure in fasting, you need to satisfy your heart and your soul. How? You ask yourself, you start off by asking yourself, why am I fasting? To lose weight? Not going to work there. Because I have to fast? Well, inshallah, that is the reason Allah may accept your fast. But we aim higher than that. If you want the pleasure of fasting, you have to know you're fasting for Allah. You really, really got to believe it. You really got to comprehend your love for Him. You really got to let it register and sink in. Once you know that Allah loves for you to fast, you'll be delighted that you're doing that which pleases Allah. If you love someone, you do that which they love and want you to do. That's the ultimate peak of showing genuine love. So are you saying Allah wants us to suffer? Allah wants you to be happy. Allah wants you to be happy. What you gain in Ramadan of taqwa, love and fear of Allah, of iman and faith, of regaining control over yourself, of winning against fighting your desires, all that is nothing compared to what's called suffering in Ramadan. Because in reality, in Ramadan, it's merely delaying the meals. How can it be actually suffering when if you go to the masses of the Muslims, they'll say their favorite month is Ramadan. They'll always say Ramadan passed by so fast. They'll say we delay our meals, we pray the night, but we can't wait to see the next Ramadan. Establish the complete tawheed in fasting. The complete tawheed in giving it all for the sake of Allah. We give it all for the sake of Allah. We give up everything for the sake of Allah. Not just our food and water. Our lives and wealth and wealth and honor. When you do that, you'll feel ecstatic. Because you've given your heart and soul the food that they need. The more you love one, the more you want to please him. The more you seek means and avenues to try to please the one you love. Dry lips and growling stomach on a normal occasion are annoying, painful at times. But when one knows he's serving Allah, it showers his heart with pleasure, like that which the Prophet ﷺ said, as long as you're not mad at me, nothing matters. The stomach is empty, but it gets full knowing Allah is watching and knowing and seeing that he left desires just for his sake. One who loves Allah wouldn't want it any other way. All the hardship one endures, yet he coats it with a head bowed down in humility and still asking Allah to accept. Because if Allah accepts it, that thirst and hunger is nothing. Again, like what the Prophet ﷺ did in At-Ta'if. The lips are dry, the throat is thirsty, but the heart gets ecstatic knowing and awaiting the day you meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the meaning of the hadith. وَفَرْحَةٌ عِنْدَ لِقَاءِ رَبِّهِ One who fasts will be overwhelmed with happiness when he meets Allah because of the deed of fasting. On the judgment day, there's people who are drenched in their sweat from their sins, based on their level of sins. Some have darkened faces. يَوْمَ تَبْيَضُّ وُجُوهًا وَتَسْوَدُّ وُجُوهًا Some people are walking on their faces. وَنَحْشُرُهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ عَلَى وُجُوهِهِمْ عُمْيًا وَبُكْمًا وَصُمًّا Some are blind, even though in the life before they could see it. وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى Then comes those who fasted. They'll be excited. They'll be overwhelmed with joy when they're meeting Allah. People are in terror and misery, yet those who fasted are bragging. They can't wait to meet Allah because the Prophet ﷺ said, وَفَرْحَةٌ عِنْدَ لِقَاءِ رَبِّهِ Someone who has not smelled the life of ihsan with Allah, which means worshiping Allah as if you see him, one who hasn't lived such a life, he may hear this and clap one hand over another in shock and say, you people are crazy. I understand fasting, and I'll do it because I have to, but to tell me to enjoy it, and you can enjoy it, not many can understand that. Because thirst and hunger on one side, and delay and enjoyment on the other side, you're really combining between opposites. There's contradictions. It's like putting two negative magnets or two positive magnets next to each other. They won't stick. Pleasure in the worship is almost like a miracle. Not many understand it, and not many attain it. Only those who Allah blessed with the level of ihsan will understand it and comprehend it and apply it. Make your intention, your purpose, and your aim the right cause for Allah and loving Allah and pleasing Allah. Your aim here is your weapon. And march forth with your fasting. You will see delight and pleasure with your fasting. We reach the high levels, inshallah ta'ala, of Jannah. We reach those levels through hardships in this world. Think about that. Think about that, and that will change it to joy. Imagine that the hardships of this life are means to gain you the high ranks of Firdaus. And we aim for the highest. Our aim is never for earthly and worldly gains. Whatever price you pay of hardship in this life is nothing in comparison to what you're going to get. It's expensive. Jannah is not cheap. It costs a lot. The Prophet said it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَلَا إِنَّ صِلْعَةَ اللَّهِ غَالِيَةً After you fix your desire to Allah and to please Allah, there's more factors to help you attain pleasure in fasting. For example, when your stomach is growling and you want that drink, and you're behind the closed doors alone with the food and water a hand reach away, and days like these where they've been sending out the heat wave warnings, all that is near you, and you're alone. You won't touch it. You become overwhelmed with joy, knowing how powerful you are over your nafs. Knowing I got some ammunition now in my dua. Now I can say, Ya Allah, I was alone, thirsty. No one knew. No one would have stopped me. I could have stopped at the restaurant on my way to Sheikh Ahmed's halaqa, and no one would have known. Not my family or Sheikh Ahmed. No one would have seen it. Oh Allah. Oh Allah. There's times when I wasn't that strong with my sin, and I committed a sin, so grant me forgiveness. That's ammunition to the dua. Ya Allah, I was alone with water and ice. They were a hand reach away. I left it for your sake. So grant me the interview, the job, the university, the illness go away, whatever it may be. That's ammunition. After you strengthen your love to Allah, after you gain ammunition to your dua, you'll only gain more pleasure knowing people will be terrorized on the judgment day. Hell is dragged to the land of the judgment day. وَجِئَ يَوْمَئِذٍ بِجَهَنَّمْ Because some people are thrown right directly into it. The messenger is shouting, Ya Rabbi Sallim Sallim. And there comes hell. In Sahih Muslim, Ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anh said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, hell will be brought, Jahannam will be brought on that day with 70,000 rings, 70,000 ropes. Each one is being pulled by an angel, with 70,000 angels pulling it. He'll say, you're going to hear people, the angels say, Abdullah, Salih, Jamal, you, away, 70 years away from Jahannam. And then another 70 years away from Jahannam. And then another 70 years away from Jahannam. Do you know what those 70 years they're pushing you away from Jahannam are? Those are days you fasted, normal days that you fasted. Every day you fasted takes you 70 years from Jahannam. And in Ramadan it's more, because that's not a normal day. Other narrations say the distance between the sky and the earth. So 70 times 30, they're going to push you 2100 years away from Jahannam. That's just for one Ramadan, let alone all the extra non-obligatory fast that you did, let alone all the other. You're going to be thousands and thousands of years from Jahannam. Tell me that doesn't bring you joy and delight to your heart when you're fasting, if you really contemplate it. Do the tafakkur, the ibadah we mentioned that is neglected ibadah. Contemplate these matters seriously. Your thirst and your hunger will become something you will enjoy. Tell me, it will not energize your heart knowing people are crowded by heaven and people are called to enter Jannah from the front yard of heaven based on their deeds. And you get called to enter the door of Ar-Rayyan. Ar-Rayyan means the door that satisfied, the door that quenches. You left a lot for the sake of Allah. Now is the time that you're going to be satisfied. That's what Ar-Rayyan means. You're called from that door. When you sit and do tafakkur in that, you contemplate it and you imagine it as it's happening. Tell me that doesn't bring you joy to your ibadah. When you're in Jannah and people are stopping at level 1 and 2 and 3 and you're going up and up, higher and higher because of your fasting. Tell me, when you do tafakkur, the ibadah that we said is neglected, when you do tafakkur and you imagine and analyze that, tell me that doesn't bring you joy and coolness to your heart in fasting. We'll stop right here. I guess that's sufficient. Jazakum Allahu khair. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept your fast and qiyam. Wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.